Where do I begin to tell my story? A story of so many secrets and so many lies. You see, it's not easy becoming transparent, letting everybody see you for who you really are and the things that you've been through. But nevertheless, maybe, just maybe, my story can open a blinding eye or bring clarity or perhaps maybe even save someone's life. But let me first say that I'm not proud of the pain that I've caused so many people. But one thing that I've come to realize is that hurt people usually tend to hurt other people. You see, it's a vicious cycle that continues from generation to generation. And it will continue to happen until somebody puts forth an effort to stop it. It's amazing how my life changed so quickly. You see, at one point, I didn't have a care in the world. And then one day I woke up and realized I was headed straight to hell. The sad part about it is that I'm not the only one. There are so many people with so many secrets and have told so many lies. Lying to others and lying to themselves. But I'm not here to talk about them. Instead, I'm here to tell you my story. I'm Mark Collins, and this is how it all began.
Yes, that's correct. Yes, this is Collins and Collins Law Firm, a family-run law practice. Yes, this is a family law firm. Yes, this is a father and son's law firm. No, but they don't handle any family law cases. Well, they only handle business and corporate law, wills and estate, traffic violations, and some real estate cases. Yes, Mr. Collins and Mr. Collins are related to each other. Of course, I'm sure they are family, but they don't handle family law. I'm sorry, we don't handle any kinds of criminal cases, even if it is against a family member. Yes, that is what I said. They are family members, but we don't... Ma'am, you don't have to be so rude. Ay, ¿por qué la gente es bien terca? ¿Por qué no pueden entender? ¿Por qué no entienden que aquí no hacemos lo que ellos
quieren? Good morning, Jim. Is everything all right?
Good morning, Mr. Collins. Yes, I am. Why do you ask?
Well, I noticed you were speaking Spanish, and you normally don't speak Spanish unless something is upsetting you.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Collins. I know that I promised you that I wouldn't do that.
That's okay, Gina. I know that can be hard to control sometimes, especially when that's your native language.
It's not just that.
Well, what do you mean?
Es que la gente es muy terca. Sometimes it's just hard to make the people understand about your law firm. They think that just because it says law firm on the building and you and Mr. Collins are related to each other, that you should practice all kinds of law. And then they get upset with me. And then it makes me get nervous. And then I start speaking in Spanish. And sometimes I'm using curse words because I really don't want to say them in English.
Okay, Gina. Now I know what's going on when I hear you speaking Spanish.
I promise I will try to control myself.
You know, Gina, I have to admit sometimes people make me say things I normally wouldn't say either. But try not to let them upset you.
Thank you for understanding, Mr. Collins.
That's no problem. Do I have any messages?
You don't have any messages, but your son, Mr. Collins, he has several new messages.
You know, he sure gets a lot of calls these days. I sure hope they're all business and not just personal calls.
Well, I don't know, Mr. Collins, but if I had to guess, I'd probably have to say that most of them are personal calls.
Wait, no, Gina. You really didn't have to answer that. That's no problem. You know, Gina, right now I'm just so happy that my boy is back here working at the firm. Because, you know, that was a time in his life I didn't know which direction he was going. Oh, but with lots of prayers, looked like he's finally got his life together.
I know that you're proud of your son. He really does seem like a good person.
Oh, well, I am proud of him, but don't tell him that. Because okay. I wouldn't want him to think I've gotten a little soft in my old age. Yeah, by the way, Gina. Did you book my flight to L.A. for tomorrow?
Yes, sir, I did. You'll be flying into Los Angeles International Airport, arriving at 10 a.m. to meet with Mr. Jeff Daniels. He's also sending a car to pick you up from the airport.
Very good, Gina. You know, I don't know where we would be around here without you. You're truly a blessing.
Thank you, Mr. Collins. That really means a lot to me. I really do like working here.
Well, and we like having you around. You're probably the best we've had in a long time.
Good morning, y'all.
Good morning, Mr. Collins.
Do I have any messages?
Yes, sir. You have 3 new messages.
Yeah, and I hope they're all business related because, son, your personal calls ain't going to pay no bills around here.
Yes, I am aware of that, Father. Thank you. And good morning to you, too, sir. Gina, what's the first message?
The first message from your doctor's appointment? They wanted to confirm your appointment today at 3 p.m.
Thanks. I mean, I had completely forgot about that. Thank you so very much.
Son, are you all right?
Yeah, Father, I'm sure it's just an annual physical thing.
Wait a minute. I thought you said you took care of that on last week.
Well, Father, I did. I'm sure they just want to discuss whatever results they found out. I'm sure everything is fine. Gina, okay. What's the next message?
Okay, and the second message from Mrs. Taylor Smith. She wants you to call her as soon as you get a chance.
Oh, Taylor.
And the third message is from Mrs. Anita Dupree. She wants you to call her as soon as possible. She said it was very, very urgent.
I wonder what that's all about. I guess I should probably go ahead and call her first.
Yeah, I guess I'll go ahead and get my day started. Gina, I have an 11:30 appointment with Mr. Carson Kelly.
Okay.
Let me know when he arrives.
Okay.
And Mark, you might want to sit in on that meeting. You can afford to learn a whole lot about wheels, son.
Yeah, for sure, Father. What he talking about? I wouldn't even plan on being in this building today. I got some stuff of my own I want to take care of.
I'm sorry, Mr. Collins, but you do have one more message.
Gina, I thought you said I only had 3 messages.
I know, I'm so sorry, but you do have one more message. It's from Mr. Shane Lucas.
From who?
From Mr. Shane Lucas.
Listen, whenever he calls, you make sure that you tell him I am not available. Do you understand me?
Yes, but he said that...
Look, I don't care what he said. Whenever he calls, I am not available. Look, I will be in my office, and please, screen all of my calls before you put any of them through, okay?
Yes, sir, I will for sure.
Thank you.
Oh, my God, but he didn't tell me what I was supposed to do when Mr. Shane Lucas shows up, because that is what the message says. Oh, my God. Oh, what am I going to do now? ¿Cómo le voy a hacer cuando usted me venga para acá? ¿Cómo le voy a decir? Oh, my God.
I hope he's not looking too good because that's going to make it that much harder. Who is it?
It's Greg. Who else would it be? Open up this door.
Come on in.
I guess you threw powder, huh? Women sure can't hold a grudge when you don't get things your way. So what's up? I know you miss me. Well, I have to admit, I missed you too, baby.
Okay, Greg, that's not what I called you over here
that's
for,
what
okay?
Your mouth is saying, but your body is calling me. But, so tell me what's on your mind, girl.
I need to talk to you, okay?
Okay, I have something I need to say to you too, but you go first.
I'm just going to say it, Greg. I don't want to see you anymore.
What?
We breaking up. It's over.
What the hell did you say?
I don't want you calling me either, Greg. It's over.
Girl,
I'm done.
Quit playing.
I'm very serious. I found myself another job, so you don't have to worry about seeing me every day.
You saying all this because I took the car from you here. You can have the keys.
It's not about your car. It's not about your car, Greg. I need to change my life before it's too late, okay?
Now, you know there isn't another man out there who will put up with all your issues. I will always be your man.
Did you forget that you are married? No. I deserve my own man, Greg.
You know, I told you I had something that I needed to tell you. Deadbeat Cheryl has filed for a divorce, so I'm all yours.
I still don't want you. You don't understand. I have to learn how to trust God now, not you.
What do you mean, trust God?
Look, every day I have been praying to do the right thing. I'm not saying it's going to be easy.
What am I supposed to do since you've given your life to God? Did God tell you to give me some of my money back?
Wait a minute.
I'm talking to you now. You're just going to...
Who is it?
Mark.
Who?
Mark.
Mark Collins?
Open the door.
What are you doing here?
Okay, baby, look, I have something very important I need to talk to you about.
Did he just call you baby?
And who is this?
The question is, who in the hell are you? Who is this?
Okay, do you plan on introducing me, or do I need to introduce myself?
Is this the loser that you... Loser. On breaking up with
me, I got your loser, partner.
Get out of my
house. Man, you ain't got no house, man. Where your house at? You don't pay no bills around here, man.
You pay the bills.
I know who you think you're talking to, man.
I'm talking
to you. You better get out of my face.
Okay, let me explain something, okay?
Now this out.
I was dating both of you, okay? That's just how it is. Don't act brand new.
What do you mean?
Okay? Don't do that. Okay, I was dating both of you, but now I want to end it with both of you.
Anita. Get your hands off her! You heard me!
You better get off me, man!
Oh, my God! No, stop it! Stop it! Both of y'all, stop! I ain't going to hell for either one of y'all fools!
Hell, what makes you think you're going to hell?
If I keep breaking God's commandments, that's where I'm going, and so will the both of you.
I'm not going to hell for neither one of you.
Anita. Baby. Anita, listen. I don't know if you're going to hell. Anita, but what I do know, Anita, you need to go get yourself checked.
Checked?
For what?
Anita, I just got my test results in it. Anita, I'm HIV positive. Hey,
this nigga, I'm...
What does that mean? What does that mean?
There's a possibility you may be infected. God. I mean, we were lovers.
Where did it come from?
I mean, you can never really tell, Anita, but what I need to tell you is that, Anita, I've been with a variety of people.
Don't. No. What is that supposed to mean, Mom? What does that mean, a variety of people?
I'm sorry.
Are you telling me so you everybody's man now?
Anita, listen.
I mean, so please tell me you're lying. Please, because... I mean, what kind of freak are you, Mark?
Listen, wait a minute. Freak? I mean, for all I know, I could have gotten a disease from you.
Oh, so this is
my
fault.
I mean, you have been sleeping with Pops over here.
I know you haven't been sleeping with this freak without using protection. Anita, how could you do this to me? If I find that the two of you have given me something, the both of you would be sorry. And by the time I get through with you, the both of you will wish you were in
hell. Just get out of here.
But don't you touch me, freak.
Anita, look. I'm sorry, baby. Just go get yourself
yeah,
checked.
Yeah, you sorry, all right.
Anita, you may not
How
be.
Could you do this to me, boy?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Why would you bring me in this mess?
Well, it was your idea.
I got kids.
But it was you who never wanted us to use protection.
Oh, so, uh-oh, I didn't see you running for CPS either, Mark Collins. Get out of my house.
Anita, let's talk.
Silence and get out.
Anita, listen to me.
Get out of my house, God. Get out. Get out. Get out.
Anita,
get out.
I'm sorry.
I hate you. Yes, you are sorry. Oh, God. What am I supposed to do now? What do I do? I know I just gave my life to you. I get it. I'm sorry, but what are my instructions at this point? Who's going to take care of my children? Who's going to take care of my baby?
They put anything on Facebook nowadays. She is wrong for posting this pic with them shoes. That's out of season. Ooh, wrong for that. A million hits? I don't think so. Wine is bad. Well, I know she didn't fall. Well, I gotta admit, this stuff is just be too funny. How these people put all their business out there like that? It's crazy. Drama, 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 drama. Check this one out, see. He wrong for this. Now look at this. This is
chance. I mean, can't you find something better to do with your time? I mean, just look at this place, man.
Look, just give me a minute. I'm gonna take care of that. You need to chill out. Chill out, okay?
Okay, when do you plan on taking care of it? Oh, I guess when you get a chance.
No, well, Mark, that is not funny, okay?
No, it's not.
What is wrong with you? What's your problem?
What is my problem? Look
here. Yes.
Chance, it's almost 6 o'clock in the evening, and just look at this place.
Like I said, okay, I'm gonna take care of it. What is the rush?
Look, you know I cannot stand a filthy house. And we both agreed that if you were gonna stay here, that you'd at least help keep the place clean.
You know what? I tell you what, excuse me for this newspaper, this shirt, and this glass, by the way, that I'm still drinking around your neat little house. Let me make sure I clean all this so we wouldn't want your little Cracker Box house to be so filthy. Okay. Coming home, tripping in me.
Look, okay, hey, look, I'm sorry, all right? Yeah,
whatever.
Look, I'm sorry. Look, I've had one of the worst days in my life, but I don't want to talk about it.
Okay, I mean, that's cool. I mean, we all have our moments.
Well, damn, at least you could have asked me what happened.
Man, didn't you say you don't want to talk about it?
You're right, I don't.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Are you absolutely sure you don't want to talk about it?
Well, I mean, if you keep insisting that I talk about it, then yeah, I guess I'll talk about it.
Okay, I'm listening.
First of all, I went to the doctor today. Got some very disturbing news today.
Are you okay?
Yeah. I mean, I guess I will be. They just have to run more tests to confirm that.
Is it anything I can help you with? I mean, what else is going on with you?
Besides that, I went by and I saw Anita today. You do remember Anita?
Yes, I do remember Anita, the one who worked at the courts, the other law firm.
Yeah.
Oh, the one you said you could hardly keep up with sexually. Yes, I remember.
Okay, yeah, that's her.
Mm-hmm, that one, that's the one.
Well, I went over there with her because she decided she wanted to break up with me. And then when I got over there, I found out she was dating some old dude, like 60-70 years old.
You mean to tell me Anita was cheating on you?
Can you believe that?
No, I thought you said it was okay for you all to see other people, though. You said that.
Well, anyway.
Yeah.
After she told me that, then, you know, I decided to share with her my bad news.
Whoa.
And then I decided to tell her the truth about some other things.
Hold on. You're not talking about the real truth, are you? Ooh, you know, I'm almost afraid to ask. What did she say? But what did she say?
Hey, what you think she said? Man, she was mad as hell. Start throwing things and hitting me and stuff.
But Mark, I told you to quit playing games with people. That is on you, and you just never want to listen to me,
no,
okay?
No, listen. I'm not playing games like that anymore. Look, I told you, I have changed. I'm a new man. I don't do that no more.
Well, I hear those same old things about Miss Taylor, too, huh?
No. See, Taylor is a totally different situation.
Really?
Yes.
So what's so different about Miss Taylor?
Taylor makes me smile.
Really?
Taylor makes me laugh.
Really?
But you know the most important thing? Is that it's because of Taylor that I got a closer relationship with God.
Okay, that's cool. And you know what? I hear what you're saying, but how could you say that when you've been with so many people? I mean, you got so many secrets, and the bottom line is when the truth comes out, somebody always gets hurt, okay?
No, for real. Not this time. I'm gonna do whatever it takes, man, to make sure that nobody gets hurt. And me and Taylor gonna make this thing work.
You know what, I hear what you're saying, and it really don't matter to me, okay? I mean, but you know how many times I've heard these same exact words about all relationships you done been in?
I don't even know why I'm having this conversation with you in the first place.
You know what, I really hope you are getting your life together, because this may be your very last wake-up call.
Wait a minute, I know you, out of all people, are not trying to tell me what to do. Well, how about you get your life together, find a job, so you can get out of my house. Mm-hmm. That way you ain't gotta worry about what I'm doing over here anyway.
Knew you was gonna go there. See, I do have a couple interviews lined up. Check that out right there. Look, can you see?
Boy, that's Facebook.
They always showing ads about who's hiring. You see, they want a fashion designer. I know about fashion.
I guess you expecting company too, right?
No, I'm not, but I can get it for you. Let me get on right over here to the door. Well, I'll do everything else around here.
Who is it?
It's Taylor.
What is she doing over here?
I don't know, but I wasn't expecting that response since she is the one you're trying to work things out with. Can you just say that right here?
Shut up.
Miss Taylor.
Hey. Hey, baby.
How are you?
I'm good.
Good, I'm good. Hey, Chance, how you doing?
Hello, Miss Taylor. Let me let you two lovebirds talk.
I'll only be here for a few minutes. I have to go pick my friend Imani up from the nail shop.
Okay, well, I'm just
going to
sit right here.
Oh, no. I'm sure you're probably missing some little new post they put on Facebook, or maybe you need to go tweet somebody.
You know what? Since you're going to put it like that, I guess I will wait in the other room. It was good to see you again, Miss Taylor.
You too, Chance. See you soon.
Hey. Baby, you know, I thought we had agreed, you know, that we would call each other, you know, before we just kind of show up at each other's house.
I tried calling you several times, and you haven't returned any of my phone calls.
Oh, wait a minute. You calling me?
Yes.
My phone is off. I'm sorry. I didn't get any of those messages. I'm so sorry.
You know, I tried calling you at work, too, and I even left you a couple of messages.
Well, you know, see, it's been such a crazy day at work. I've been in and out of the office all day long today. I'm so sorry. I didn't get any of those messages either, babe. I'm sorry.
You know, it's been real crazy for me, too. You know, and that's why I at least needed to see you or hear from you, because you really know how to relieve some of my stress, and right now would be a good time to relieve that stress, if you know what I mean.
No, baby, wait. Oh, Chance. Chance is right there in the other room.
He was here the other day knocking on the wall whenever we got too loud, so.
But baby, wait a minute. Imani, remember you. You gotta go get a money.
I can settle for a quickie this time, okay?
Baby, but a minute. Hey, babe, I mean, I just got here from work, and I told you I'm really tired right now. So, a lot of stuff I need to take care of.
Okay. I guess I'll leave you to handle your business. Sorry I came by forcing myself on you. Somebody who obviously has no time for me.
Look, I'm sorry. Look, it's not like that. Okay, how about we get together a little later tonight, okay?
Okay, that sounds good.
Great.
I have the house to myself. Malik will be gone.
Oh, wow, that sounds wonderful. So I'll be over a little later?
Yeah, okay. Do you want me to cook something?
I'll leave that totally up to you. But if not, I mean, we could always go out and get something to eat.
Good, because I really don't feel like cooking.
I didn't know. Well, all right, baby. Take care, okay? And I'll see you soon.
All right, see you.
All right, baby.
Okay.
Okay.
I love you.
All right, baby. I'll see you soon.
Sounds like you might need to have that little talk with that one, too.
Chance, like I said before, this really doesn't concern you, sir.
Yeah, but I really hope you know what you're doing.
In case you've forgotten, sir, I'm Mark Collins, and I always handle my business.
Hold on for a second. You got a call from a Shane Lucas.
For who?
Shane Lucas. He said you all had some unfinished business y'all need to tend to. Who is that anyway?
Look, somebody from my past that I wish would just go far, far away and just leave me the hell alone. Let me go take a shower, because
Hold on before you do that, because I was the last one to use it. Let me make sure it's clean, okay?
Yeah, why don't you do that? Because I'm not going to keep cleaning up behind you.
Hey, you know what? You just big time lawyer. You ever heard of Molly Maid with the ones with the little bitty cars? How about you call them? That would help you out and help me out around here. How about that?
Hey, what do I need that for when I got you?
Oh, whatever.
You know, by the way, go on, clean up this bathroom.
You need to quit playing.
What kind of conditioner do you use on this?
Honey, I'll only be a few minutes. My feet.
Wow.
Take the pain.
More. Yes, you've forgotten, darling. There is a price to pay for beauty.
And I guess right now my feet are paying that price. Oh, they hurt so bad.
Well, why don't you go change them then?
I am.
You know, not everybody can do beauty, girl. Ooh, I love this mirror. So anyway, that's why you should have came and got you a pedicure with me today. At least then your toes would have looked good while you were in pain. And girl, how does your work? I know you could have used one.
Because I've seen them jacked up toes before.
Hey, I heard that.
Oops, my bad.
Don't make me get started on those sledgehammer toes you have. You don't want me to do that, do you?
Oh, no, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
I can't help it because I was cursed with my daddy's feet. But that's all right, because now they are polished and looking good. Look, it's called Ready Red. Look at that. They're cute. Ooh, anyway, where's little Malik?
Oh, his daddy picked them up for the weekend, and I'm so glad about it. Woo! I finally got some time for myself.
I have no idea how you do it. Oh, my gosh, you are so good. I mean, you are a full-time mom. You work full-time. You're active in the church. You participate in all your child's after-school activities. Ooh, girl, you are my shero.
It can be a bit overwhelming, but, you know, thanks to God, he always causes me to triumph.
See, you're making me feel bad. Here I am. I do have a full-time job, but as you know, I don't have a man. Uh-uh. I don't have any children. But I do have a goldfish that I sometimes forget to feed. Poor little Ting Ting. But, you know, I just can't find time for anything else. Girl, I'm just so busy.
You know, that means you spend entirely too much time sleeping your life away.
Hello? If I want to remain beautiful, then I must find time for my beauty rest. Wouldn't you agree?
That's what you call it.
Girl, you know I'm cute. Quit playing.
I will sleep on, my sister. Sleep on.
I know, right? Anyway, speaking of time, you've now added a man to your busy lifestyle. A man I still haven't met yet.
Who, Mark? Mark Collins?
My goodness, I guess that must be him because you're showing every tooth you have. Good Lord.
That's because Mark is truly a blessing. I thank God for him, girl.
Really? Yes. You know what? I'm so glad things are working out for you, too. I'm really happy about that.
So far it is. I mean, I have no complaints. And I do mean no complaints. He is so good to me.
No complaints, huh? Isn't this the same guy you told me sometimes comes up missing in action?
Ugh, yes, that's the only thing I can't stand about him. But, you know, he does find time for me and Malik, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And how does little Malik feel about him?
Girl, he loves him. You know, Mark spends a lot of time with him by himself, and it really gives me a break.
Whoa, by himself?
Yeah.
Girl, you sure you can trust this man? There are a lot of perverted people out there. They try to get in all good with the mama.
Oh, my God.
Really trying to get in good with the child. You gotta watch him.
Don't say things like that. Mark is a good man. He comes from a good family, and I can already tell he's gonna be a great father figure to Malik.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Speaking of father, what is this dude's story anyway? Is he married? Has he ever been married?
No.
How many children does he have? He probably got like 10 or 20. Is he gay?
Calm down. Calm down. He is single, okay? He works for Collins Law Firm, and he has no children.
What?
No children.
Did you say no children?
Yes.
Girl, you mean to tell me there's still men on the market like that?
They're out there, Imani. There is still something.
Ooh, well, praise Jesus, because baby, I'm telling you. Wow, when do I get to meet him and see if he have a friend?
You'll meet him soon.
How soon is soon, Taylor?
Imani, come on. I don't want to start bringing him around my friends before I really get to know him. I got to make sure he's the one.
Taylor, what determines if this guy's the right one? What? His skin color, his job, the size of his wallet. Oh, the size of his, you know. Yeah, that's what it is. I understand. I ain't even mad at you, girl.
No. It's gotta feel right, you know? And right now, it just doesn't feel quite right.
Well, there gotta be something wrong with him because, you know, ain't nobody perfect.
Yeah, you're right, but I guess I'm just gonna take it one day at a time.
Well, you know what? You're right. Just focus on his good qualities. Don't worry about the bad. You'll be all right.
You know, I really, really like Mark because we have so much in common. We both like to laugh and eat.
Yeah, you skinny folks always eat. Y'all make me sick.
The most important thing is we both love God.
Now, see, that's what you're talking about right there. That is the most important thing. And speaking of God, have you asked God if Mark Collins is the one?
Let's just say I prayed, and then one day, Mark Collins shows up.
Oh, girl, you need to teach me how to pray like this. I've been praying for years. And the only people that ever show up for me are criminals and convicts. They've been in the jail or going to jail.
You know, that says a lot about you. We tend to attract what we are.
No, you didn't. What you trying to say, Taylor?
I'm explaining. Okay, I'm going to explain it to you in the car because you got to go. I have a date with my man tonight.
Really? Oh, look, I have a date, too. Girl, my bed is calling me as we speak.
It's crazy.
Tim, are you sure that we really have to go? Come on, let me just, you know, look in your closet. Just be in there for a minute. Come on, let me get a peek at it.
No. Honey, you will not fit in my closet. There are way too many shoes in there.
Yeah, any excuse will do, Taylor. He must be ugly. That's the real reason you don't want me to see
this old thing. Have a seat.
Thanks.
Can I get you anything?
No, I'm fine, thank you.
I was beginning to think you weren't coming. It was getting kind of late.
Oh, now come on, baby, you should know me by now. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm typically a man of my word. And besides that, I didn't want to disappoint you.
Well, you haven't disappointed me this far, so how about we keep that record going?
Wait a minute, baby. I mean, you mean to tell me you got all dressed up just to get undressed?
Trust me, it comes off just as easy as it came on. So come on.
Wait a minute, baby. I mean, what's the rush?
Look, we haven't been with each other in a while now, and right now would be the perfect time to, you know.
Baby, look, I do know that it's been a while. But, baby, again, what's the rush? I'm not going anywhere.
Mark, sex is really important to our relationship.
You are too much. I mean,
what's so funny?
You. I mean, think about it, baby. When we first got together, I mean, I practically had to beg you just to get a hug and kiss from you. I mean, I never thought in a million years that we'd be making love.
Mark, that's because I was practicing celibacy for the past 7 years and I was trying to do what was right.
Oh, okay. I get it. So now that we got together, you no longer want to do what's right.
That is not funny. Okay, look, you know that we have a special connection with each other. I just know that you're different.
Baby, yes, I'm different, but our relationship should not be based on how much lovemaking we share. And I mean, and besides that, I mean, what if something happens and, I mean, then what?
Mark, what's wrong with you? You weren't talking like this just last week. Do you want me to show you all the kinky text messages you were sending me on my phone?
No. Because
I got
them. Look, I'm fine, okay? It's just that I'm a little tired. I had a long, hard, and stressful day today at work. That's all.
Well, you sure it's not something else because you're really not acting like your normal self.
I'm positive. It's nothing else, okay? Look, it's just my job. I mean, my dad, he's constantly pressuring me about getting new clients. He want me to sit in on all these boring meetings. I'm just stressed.
Mark, I understand that you have a business to run, but I'm talking about us.
What about us?
Well, it seems like lately I'm the only one making all the phone calls. You don't call me anymore.
Well, I told you before, baby, that I was a very busy man. And that my job, I mean, it really does take up a lot of my time.
And lately, when I want to make love, you don't want to make love.
Oh, wait a minute, you can't blame me for that.
I mean, somebody is always at your house, or Chance is always at my house. I mean, do you realize how much, how it takes the excitement out of it for me, trying to contain this explosion?
Come on, nobody is here right now. You can be as loud as you want to, see? Woo! You're still not touching me. See? Mark, are you seeing someone else?
Tell me, you can't be, I mean, I barely have time to see you.
That's it. You're too busy seeing her, so you don't have time to see me. Come on, Mark, you can tell me.
You can't be serious.
Mark, I am very, very serious.
You know what, really, I'm just not in the mood for this today.
Apparently, you're not in the mood for anything today.
I cannot believe that you are getting this upset because I'm too tired to have sex.
Too tired to have sex? That's all it is to you, sex? You don't even use the term lovemaking. See, this is how I know something is wrong.
Wait a minute. Taylor, do you trust me?
Yes, but it's getting hard.
Okay, wait a minute. What have I done to make you not trust me? I could just think about it. If you don't trust me now, it's gonna be real hard for us to have a real relationship.
Mark, it's getting real hard to trust you when you're acting like the guys from my past relationships.
Baby, listen, I've told you before, I'm not like any guy that you've been with in the past, nor am I like any guy that you'll ever be with in the future.
Are you bragging on yourself, Mark Collins?
If I don't, then who will? Oh. No, look, I'm just kidding. Seriously, baby, seriously. Taylor, I really am. I'm a good man. And you will see that in time, baby.
Mark, I know that you're a good man, but you have to understand. I don't want to be hurt again by anybody. Can you promise me that you won't hurt me?
Taylor, baby, the only thing that I can promise you is that I will never intentionally hurt you. Because, Taylor, I do love you.
You love me? You love me. I never heard you say that before. I'm sorry.
Of course I love you. Hey, look, and since you seem to be feeling better, and I don't smell nothing cooking, how about we go get a bite to eat? I mean, you look too good just to stay in the house.
Okay, but after dinner, you have to see how good I really look. Come on.
Hey, you said nothing but a thing. Let's do this.
I'm sorry, he's not in the office. May I take a message for him? Okay. Okay. Yes, okay. I'll make sure he gets a message. Thank you for calling. You have a good day. Goodbye. Good morning.
Good morning.
May I help you?
I am here to see Mr. Collins, please.
Which Collins are you here to see? Charles Collins or Mark Collins?
Actually, I can see either one. It really doesn't matter.
Well, are you a client? Do you have an appointment?
No, I don't have an appointment, but I can speak to whoever is available first.
Well, they normally don't take walk-ins. Can I schedule for an appointment for another date? Do you have a preference of who you would like to see?
Look, sweetie, I need you to tell me if either one of them are here right now, because I need to talk to them.
Okay. Well, as of right now, neither one of them are in the office.
Then I'll wait, if that's okay with you.
Well, I'm really not sure if that's a good idea or not, because I'm really not sure what time they both will arrive. Can you please tell me what this is in regards to?
I'm actually looking for legal representation.
Just one minute, ma'am. Excuse me. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. I'm here to see Mark.
Mr. Collins is not in the office. Do you have an appointment?
No, I don't, but I'll wait until he gets here.
But I'm really not sure what time he will arrive.
It doesn't matter. I'll wait all day if necessary.
And so will I.
Well, let me just make sure I got this right. Ma'am, you're planning on waiting and you're willing to see either one of the Collins, correct?
Ding, 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 ding. That's correct.
And sir, you're here to see Mark Collins, correct?
That's right. I'm here to see Mark.
Well, do you mind if I get your name?
Go ahead. Ladies first.
My name is Anita Dupree.
Now, why does your name sound so familiar?
And your name, sir?
My name is Shane Lucas.
Ay, Dios mío, este es el hombre que llamó hace rato. Oh, my God, did you say Shane Lucas?
Yes, I did. Oh, my God, you're speaking to me, I don't understand Spanish. Come on, you're in America. Come on now.
Good morning, Gina.
Buenos días, yes, good morning. How you doing?
Do I have any messages?
Yes, sir, Mrs. Natalie Kelly called. She wants you to return her
call. Excuse me, Mr. Collins. May I speak with you for a moment, please, sir?
And this is Mrs. Anita Dupree. She doesn't have an appointment, and Mr. Wells is scheduled for 10. I tried to schedule her one for a later date, but she insisted she wanted to talk to you today.
Yeah. What about him? Are they together?
No, we are not.
No, sir, I'm here to see your son.
He's not here yet, but is that something I can help you with?
No, you can help her. She was here first. I'll wait for your son, because this only concerns he and I.
Can I ask if this is a personal matter?
Yes, very personal.
And so is my situation, Mr. Collins?
Well, I do have a few minutes before my 10 o'clock arrives. Just what can I do for you, Ms. Collins?
Actually, I'm looking for an attorney to take my case, but I'm not sure if you will be able to take it.
Wait a minute. Why do you look so familiar?
That's what I said.
Where do I know you?
That's what I said.
Do you work down at the courts?
Actually, I work for Katine and Lechman's law firm. I work for Mitchell.
Oh, Mitchell. Hell, I've known those guys for a long time.
Exactly.
They're good lawyers, too.
Yeah.
But how can I help you?
I also used to candidate your son, Mark.
I thought I knew that name. Miss Anita Dupree. I've heard lots and lots of stories about you.
And excuse me, who are you?
My name is Shane Lucas, and I'm a friend of Mark's. And he used to talk about you. All the time.
Well, I'm almost positive Mark has never mentioned your name before. Excuse me, Mr. Collins, is there somewhere we can speak in private, please?
Yes, we can go to my office.
Thank you, because what I need to say needs to be said in private.
Really, Ms. Dupree, are you sure we can't just schedule this another time? I really don't have a lot of time right now.
Mr. Collins, I promise you, it will only take a moment.
Well, Ms. Dupree, follow me to my office.
Thank you. Peasant.
Gina, when Mr. Wells arrives at 10:30, let me know and offer him some coffee.
Yes, sir, I'll take care of it.
What? Sure. Ain't nobody offered me no coffee since I've been sitting here.
I'm so sorry. Can I get you some coffee while you wait?
No, that's okay. I don't drink coffee because it's bad for your health and it stains your teeth. But I will tell you what you can get me. Get me a cold bottle of water because I got a feeling things about to get pretty heated around here.
Okay, then I'll be right back.
Oh, take your time. I'm not going anywhere, and I do mean that.
Good morning, Gina. How you doing?
Mr. Collins, ya hace rato le traté de decirte que esto me iba a venir para acá, pero usted no
me dijo
que no
listen to me. Gina,
never wanted
to listen. I simply asked how you were. You know what? Do I have any new messages?
I don't know about any new messages, but you sure do have an old friend that's here to see you.
Oh, Mr. Collins, you really should learn Spanish. That is what I was trying to tell you, that you had a good year.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I think you know. I'm here to see my long-lost friend. Long time no see. Player.
Is everything all right, Mr. Collins?
Yes, Gina. Could you just give us a few minutes, please? This won't take but a second.
But what about the telephone? Who's going to answer the phone and be here for Mr. Collins to call the appointment?
Just let the phones ring. When the appointment gets here, I'll take care of it, okay?
Okay, Mr. Collins, I'll give you your privacy, but are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Sure,
thank you,
Jimmy. Want me to get security?
No, oh, I'm fine. Thank you.
Now tell me, what the hell are you doing here?
Well, since you decided not to return any of my calls, I decided to come and see for myself what was going on with you these days.
No, I'm serious. What are you doing here in Houston when you live in Chicago?
Man, for one thing, the weather's a lot better here in Houston. And another thing, I had to come and check up my investment. And from what I could see, my investment seemed to be doing pretty good.
Oh, okay, look. I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to ask you to leave. Because, I mean, this is not the place nor the time for this, okay?
Well, you tell me, when will be a good time then?
I tell you what, just give me your number and I promise you I'll set something up, okay?
Oh, man, I hear you talking, but why not here and why not right now? After all, it's the only place I can seem to find your sorry ass.
Look, because this is my father's place of business, okay? And look, I really don't want to cause a scene.
Oh, man, I guess you changed then, because the Mark Collins I knew, he would do anything anywhere. and it didn't matter if it caused a scene or not, especially if the price was right.
I know what you're saying, but I promise you, we can set something up a little later. I really do have a lot of work I need to take care of.
Oh, man, since when are you so concerned about work? And anyway, you one of the bosses here. Your name is on that sign outside. Collins and Collins Law Firm. Okay. You can leave whenever you want.
Look, I know, but I can't leave right now, okay? I already have clients set up for today.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what about this? Okay. Let's meet at your place tonight when you get off.
That's fine.
Oh, wait a minute. You got that pretty boy with all that pretty hair living with you now, don't you? By the way, is that your new little boy toy?
Look, now you know it is nothing like that. Look, Chance is just my friend. I'm simply trying to help him out because he's down on his luck.
Man, if you say so, Mark, because I can never tell about you. One day you want to be with a man, and the next day you want to be with a woman.
Then you know that's a lie.
What part is a lie, Mark? I'm listening. Oh, that's right. From what I hear, you a changed man, and you into women these days. But you know what? One of your girlfriends is in it right now talking to your dear old dad.
What are you talking? Who are you talking
about? Oh, man, you know what I'm talking about. Miss Anita Dupree, the one you used to call the freak of the week.
What is she doing here?
I don't know, and honestly, I don't care. The only thing I'm concerned about is you meeting with me tonight.
Okay, listen. I promise you, we can set something up. Just pick the place, pick the time. I'll be there.
Okay, meet me at Nola's Cafe right after work.
Okay.
And Mark, you better not disappoint me, or you'll be so sorry that you did.
Why does it always seem like the devil shows up when you're trying to get your life right?
Is it all right if I come back to my desk? I just saw Shane Lucas leave.
Yes.
Are you okay?
Yes, Gina. Everything is fine. Thank you. But Gina, look. Are you a praying woman?
Yes, of course I am. Why?
Because I honestly feel like I'm going to need you to pray for me. Mm-hmm. Seems like the sins of my past have finally caught up with me.
You can sure say that again, son.
Hey. Anita. Hey, what are you doing here?
Good afternoon, Mark Collins.
How are you? Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine. I'm looking for an attorney to take my case.
Yeah, she wants me to represent her with a case, son.
Well, I mean, what kind of case? Is something wrong? Are you all right?
Oh, in the end, baby, everything will be just fine.
Okay. Yeah. Is there something I can
do? No, son. You can't help at all. She wants to file a lawsuit against you for infecting her with the HIV virus.
What the hell did you just say?
Well, you better watch your mouth.
You heard him.
No. I mean, how can you come over here and sue me? I mean, when you've been with so many other men.
Well, but all the men I've been with didn't come to my house and tell me they were HIV positive. Now, did they, Mark Collins?
Is this true, son? Answer me!
Yes. I mean, but for all I know, I could have gotten the disease from Anita.
You are such a liar. I know for a fact I didn't give it to you.
Okay, look, why don't you go and get all your other friends checked before you come over here spreading lies about me?
None of my other friends have admitted to sleeping with a man before.
Oh, I've heard enough. I don't want to hear
honestly say that.
Are you happy now, Anita? I mean, look what you've done.
Happy? How the hell can I be happy? Look what you've done to me. Look what you've done to my children. I hate you, Mark Collins.
I really don't have time for this.
Oh, you
I
don't.
Really, I don't have time for this.
Neither one of us have time for it, honey. But it happened to the both of us. Go on and run. Do what you always do. It ain't gonna change nothing. Good day.
My job, talking all crazy to me.
Mark,
I just don't understand.
Mark, what is going
look,
on?
Look, just not now, okay? Just leave me the hell alone.
Look, I'm gonna need you to calm down and tell me what's going on.
Look, my whole life is falling apart and there's no way to stop it.
Look, what are you talking about? Can you just take a minute to breathe? Huh?
Look, I don't know who it is that unlocked the doors of hell, but it's like I've been under attack all week long.
Okay, look, trust me, I'm sure this will pass. Everything will be okay.
No! Look, things will never be all right ever again.
Ooh. You know what? You need to calm down. Come on, sit down and tell me what's going on.
Look, you got people showing up from my past, people trying to sue me over stuff that's not even my fault.
OK, okay. Like I said, I'm sure everything will be okay.
Just why is it? Why I can't get some good news? Just for once. Just for once.
Well, I got some good news and I also got some bad news. Which one you want to hear first?
It doesn't matter, okay? I don't care. Just no, you know what? On second thought, go ahead and give me the good news because I've heard enough bad news for one day.
Okay. Got a job. I'm gonna be back working in the club bartending.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay, well, in that case then, what's the bad news then?
Well, the job is located in Chicago, so, you know, I'm gonna have to move to Chicago.
Just how the hell did you find a job way in Chicago when I can barely get you to leave this apartment right here in Houston?
Because I helped them.
Yeah,
I just made a few calls to some of my friends, and you know how the rest works.
What the hell are you doing here?
Just sitting here, taking a chance by talking to chance.
No, yeah, I'm serious. What are you doing here in my house?
I knew you wouldn't be a man of your word, so I came here instead. And Chance said it was all right if I waited until you got home. Look, and he and I just started talking about things.
Look, you didn't give me enough time. I just got off of work.
That's because I give you enough damn time, and your time is up.
Okay, that's my cue to leave. Thank you, Shane, for the job. I just can't.
Oh, no problem. I always like helping my friends out, especially my new friends that seem to have a lot of potential.
Potential?
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Yeah.
What is it that you want from me, man? I mean, it's obvious that the devil is already after my soul, so I have nothing else to offer you.
Man, I just want you to suffer the way you caused me to suffer. After all I've done for you in the past, and you just walked away from me without any kind of explanation.
Man, I had to leave, okay? I just got tired of living a double life.
Man, no one told you to live a double life in the first place. All you had to do was pick one life and go with that.
And that's what I did. Man, I just couldn't take that type of lifestyle anymore, man.
Oh, but you sure did take the money, the fine cars, the fine jewelry, and luxurious lifestyle that went along with that kind of lifestyle.
Wait a minute. Because if that is what this is all about, dude, I will pay you every single dime that you ever gave me.
Man, this is not about the money. I got plenty of money. You've hurt my business connections. People were requesting you, and you were nowhere to be found. Do you realize how much money you lost me? You could have at least told me you were leaving town.
Look, man, I had to leave, okay? My father needed my help, so I had to leave. But, man, I really need to get that.
Man, go ahead. This is your place.
Who is it?
It's me, son. Open the door.
Man, look, I really need to talk to you. I've been trying to get in touch with you all day
long. What's going on? I'm sorry. I didn't know you had company. I see you finally caught up with my son.
Yes, sir. I sure did.
Well, excuse me. I really need to talk to my son. You mind if we talk in private for a minute?
Okay. I'll just go finish talking to Chance.
No. Look. I really do need to talk to my father. We'll set something up, but I promise I'll holler at you later, okay?
Okay, but you better make sure you holler at me later, or I'll be back for sure. Okay. You hear me, Mark?
Yes.
Who is he anyway? Well, something ain't quite right about him. I just don't seem to like him too much.
Father, he's nobody. Just pay him no mind, okay? Well, I mean, but what's going on anyway?
Man, look, I really need to talk to you. I'm a little troubled by something I heard today.
Father, I know what you want to talk about, but can we please just
Oh, man, we're going to talk right now.
Okay. I mean, since you insist, what is it you want to know?
Man, look. Man, first, tell me, son, are you really HIV positive?
Dad, according to my test results, I am. Oh. But, Father, I have to take more tests just to confirm.
So, what would make you do a thing like this?
At one point in my life, I was a little confused, okay?
Wait a minute, so how did you get this disease? Are you gay or bisexual on the down low? Man, what is your story?
I wouldn't say that I'm gay, okay? I've done some things in my past that I'm not proud of.
Man, what would make you do something like that anyway? I don't understand.
No.
a little confused, okay? So don't you know that type of lifestyle is an abomination to the Lord? So you would die and burn in hell for being gay.
Who said that I was gay? I mean, what if I didn't have a choice, then what?
Oh, come on, man. You do have a choice. All you gotta do is either say yes or no to that type of lifestyle and meet it. You do have a choice.
I'm not doing that stuff anymore. And I really am a changed man. I'm trying to do things God's way.
Man. You have told me, man, you disappointed me, son. And you disgraced my family's name. Yes, you are, son. My only.
Look, this has nothing to do with you or any family name. I'm sure you've done some things in your life that wasn't Christ-like.
Oh, but nothing quite perverted like you.
But you know what? See, the God that I serve, the God that I know, see, sin is still sin. So if I'm gonna burn in hell, then so will you.
Don't you dare stand there and try to turn this around on me when it is you that should be blamed for all of your sinful actions.
Blame?
Yes.
No, if you wanna blame somebody, I blame you. Because you should have done a better job at protecting me.
Well, son,
then maybe none of this would have happened.
I've always protected you, son.
Maybe you should have done a better job at protecting me from Mr. Phillips.
Who in the hell is Mr. Phillips?
Miss Lucy's husband? Oh. Yeah, you know the lady that you used to let babysit me? Because you were so busy taking care of things right after Mom died. It was Mr. Phillips, Dad. It was Mr. Phillips that sexually assaulted me for years. And nobody stopped him.
So, why didn't you just say something? I didn't know.
What was I supposed to say? Oh. I was just a child. And all I wanted to do was just be a child. But I'd never get that chance again. Thanks to you and Mr. Phillips.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm so sorry. Well, I didn't know. Why didn't you just say something back then? I could have got you some help. So we could have at least prayed about it. Yes, we could have.
Don't you know how many times I've been praying? Don't you know how many times I've asked God to take this from me? I mean, this is something that I think no man should ever have to endure.
I know you blame me. I know how you feel. It's easy to blame others when you're hurting. I did it for years. I blame your mother for dying.
How can you blame my mother?
If she would have died, none of this would have ever happened.
Look, she didn't ask to get breast cancer. My mother didn't ask to die. I'm sure she wanted to be here for her family just like you.
I hate to interrupt y'all little conversation, but I got something I need to say.
Chance, please, okay?
No.
Just give us a few minutes, Chance.
No, not for you, for Mr. Collins. So, Mr. Collins, you got something against homosexuals? Because I'm gay, and I'm proud to be gay. Matter of fact, I've been gay all my life, okay? And it ain't what because somebody took advantage of me either, okay? Really.
Look, Chance, hell, I've always known you were gay.
Really?
I ain't never known you'd have a girlfriend or woman, but you know what? This ain't about you. This is about my son, brother. I'm not concerned about your issue.
But I just get tired of everybody making a big deal about it. If you gay, they always got something wrong to say about gay people.
Chance,
for real.
Please, okay?
No, I heard what he said. I don't think it's right. So, Mr. Collins, you think I'm going to hell because I'm gay? Look, I was born like this, all right? And you have no right to judge me or my lifestyle, okay?
Chance, really.
All I can go by is what the Bible says. And if the Bible says being gay is wrong, then it is wrong!
Well, don't God love everybody?
Oh, God.
Didn't Jesus die for my sins, too? You still have no right to judge me or my lifestyle, okay? Really.
Chance, if you want to take a chance on your soul spending an eternity in hell, then that is on you. And don't you dare stand there and try to say you were born that way. But my advice to you, son, if you say you were born that way, then I advise you to be born again in Jesus Christ. This ain't about you.
But you still have no right to judge me or my lifestyle.
Chance! Let it go. Okay? It's your lifestyle. Live it the way you want to live it. Because, see, my father, he doesn't have a heaven or a hell to put either one of us in.
So don't.
You know what?
You know, you're right. So the heck with both of y'all. But you'll never be able to say that I didn't try to tell you the truth. You know what? That is your daddy for real. Well, it's you.
Break you and Mark up.
But what if it's true? What am I gonna do?
I don't know. I've never been in a predicament like this. You know, I don't have a man. And, I haven't had a man in a long time.
Imani!
I'm sorry, but you know, it's okay. It doesn't matter. Because you were smart and you used protection. So you're safe. You did use protection, right? Please tell me you used protection.
I did the first few times, but then we just got comfortable and we stopped.
Oh my God, Taylor, how could you be so stupid? When you know that HIV and AIDS are the leading cause of death among black women, especially here in Houston, straight black women.
Imani, I called you over here to make me feel better, not make me feel worse.
Okay, well, what if he does have AIDS, Taylor? What if he's on the down low? What if he gave you AIDS? Then what? Oh, I can't believe you. Oh, my God.
Imani, what am I gonna do?
You know what? Just call him again. And what did the Shane guy say anyway?
He told me he wanted me to meet him at Mark's apartment tonight.
So, would you tell him, are you going?
No! I hung up. I'm too scared to go.
Look, I'll go with you if you want to go. But let's just take your gun, just in case.
Just in case for what? I'm not doing that.
Because if it is true, you can shoot Mark like the low-down, dirty dog that he is. And if it's not true, you can shoot this Shane guy for causing all this worry and telling lies.
That's not gonna help either. Why is this happening to me? I really thought Mark was the one.
You know what, honey? Let's just pray that it's not true, okay?
Why would God let something like this happen to me?
Oh, wait a minute. Pump your brakes, sister. You can't blame God for this. This was your decision.
God sent him to me, Imani.
Oh, really?
Yes.
The last time I checked, God only sent good and perfect gifts.
But I prayed and I asked God for a good man, and then Mark Collins shows up.
You know, Taylor, I've heard you say that before. But how do you know that Mark wasn't sent from the devil?
Because he had too many good qualities.
Don't you know that the devil can transform himself into an angel of light? That he comes to destroy and deceive God's people? He is the master deceiver.
Imani, I really don't feel like hearing this right now. It's not helping.
Well, I think it's time you do hear it. You call yourself a Christian, right?
Yes. And what does that have to do with anything?
I get so tired of Christian women lowering their standards of their beliefs just to have a man.
Imani, sweetie, that doesn't apply to me because I never lowered my standards.
Oh, really?
Yes, really.
Well, sweetie, at one time, you were celibate and standing on the promises of God. And the minute Mark Collins comes along, all that went right out the window with your panties.
You know, that's real easy for you to say because you don't have a man. Let's see what happens when your Mr. Right comes along.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
You know what? You're right. I don't have a man. But the reason I don't have a man the minute they find out I'm not going to lower my standards to be with them, they are just ready to go and out the door. And you know what I say? Oh, well, next.
You really picked the time to preach to me right now as if I already don't have enough on my mind.
You know, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to make you feel bad, but I see this all the time. Christian women will do whatever it takes just to have a man. They don't care if he's gay, on the down low, married,
come on,
and heaven forbid, broke. They just want a man in their lives, any man.
Imani, but I really don't feel like hearing this right now. It's not helping.
Who is that? You know, what if it's Mark? Where's your gun?
Who is it?
It's Anita Dupree.
Who?
Anita Dupree, I need to talk to you about a friend of ours. Mark Collins.
Ooh, let her in.
Come in. Have a seat.
Seen Mark Collins, correct?
Yes, I am, but how do you know that?
And how did you know where she lived?
I'm also dating Mark Collins, and I work in a law firm, so I can pretty much get any information that I need to get.
What do you mean you're also dating Mark Collins?
Excuse me, who are you?
Why don't you go to your little law firm and find out so you can find out anything?
Hey, honey, just let her finish.
Me and Mark have been friends for a very long time, and he told me all about you.
Hmm.
So I knew he was seeing other people, and it was okay. And I'm seeing other people, so it worked out for a while.
Why are you here again?
Look, I'm not here to cause trouble. I just felt like Mark shouldn't get away with what he's been doing. Taylor should know all the hell he's been putting me through.
What are you talking about?
Well, as much as I do love Mark, I've come to realize that he can't be trusted and he's a liar.
Ding, ding, ding.
How long have you been seeing Mark?
Well, on and off for about 3 years.
Wow.
Well, I've only been seeing him for 6 months.
Thank God that it hasn't been for much longer. You know, Taylor, are you sleeping with Mark?
No, she didn't.
I don't think that's any of your business.
Tell her, girl, none of your business.
Is it any of your business that Mark came to my house a few days ago and told me he was HIV positive?
Ooh. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Of course, that prompted me to go to the clinic and get myself tested and when you know it, so am I.
You know what? If this is true, why didn't Mark tell me? He tells me everything.
Oh. Including about his past. How he used to sleep with a variety of people, including women and men. Did he tell you that, Taylor?
You know, you've said enough.
Will you just leave? If you ask me, she said way too much.
I'll take that. I pray God covers you, and you won't have to go through all the hurt that I've had to go through with Mark.
Anita, would you please just quit talking and leave?
Look, Taylor, I'm dying, okay? He's ruined my whole life. I couldn't stand here and watch him just ruin another woman's life.
Please just leave, please.
I'll leave. But know this. I'm praying for you, sister.
Whoa. How can you possibly call her sister when you continue to sleep with Mark and you knew he had a girlfriend? You know what? It's obvious. You are getting everything you deserve. Just get out of here, everybody's woman.
Be mad at me. Hell, be mad at Mark. Be mad at everybody. Get yourself checked for yourself, for Malik. Don't say I didn't warn you.
What am I gonna do? It's okay. Why is this happening to me?
It's okay. You know, Mark has told so many secrets and so many lies.
We cannot keep letting him get away with this.
Taylor, you gotta remember, God said vengeance is mine. We've gotta trust God and know that he's gonna handle this. You've gotta trust him, honey. But there's certainly nothing wrong with keeping a loaded 357 in the house. So let's go get you cleaned up so we can go to the pawn shop and get you some bullets, because you're looking a hot mess. Come on. ABC Pawn, do you guys carry bullets?
Your message. I wanted to make sure you were all right.
Baby, huh? I wonder how often he uses that line.
Hey, baby. Excuse me.
Imani, do you mind if I talk to Mark alone?
Imani? Look, nice to meet you. Look, I'm sorry. I've heard so much about you. Look, nice to meet you, okay?
I've heard a lot about you, too. Enough to last me a lifetime. Imani, do you mind if I just speak to Mark alone, please? Sure, no problem. I'll be right in the back, headed straight for your closet. No. You can leave. I'll be all right. Are you sure?
Yes.
Are you absolutely sure? You know, because I don't mind staying.
I'm sure. I'll be all right.
Okay, I'm going to leave, but promise me you're going to call me as soon as this one leaves.
I will, I promise.
You be careful. You know what? I'm sorry. Mark, where are my manners? You know what? I'd like to say it's been a pleasure meeting you. But that would be a lie.
Taylor, I'll be at the pawn shop looking for bullets if you need me.
Okay. Is her problem? What is going on with her?
No, what the hell is your
Taylor,
problem?
What is wrong with you?
Are you a lucky I didn't shoot you?
Taylor, look, what are you talking about?
Why would you do this to me?
Do what, Taylor? What are you talking
is
about?
Is it true? Just tell me, is it true?
Is what true?
That you're gay. And that you've been sleeping with both women and men for
look,
money.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Mark, you might as well tell me the truth because I already know that it's true. I just want to hear you say it.
Taylor,
now tell me.
I'm going to say this one more time, okay? I have no idea what you're talking about or where you're getting this information from.
From Shane Lucas and Anita Dupree. So I guess both of them are lying.
I mean, Shane and Anita, I mean, what they got to do with this?
First, I get a call from Shane Lucas. Then Miss Anita Dupree pays me a visit. As a matter of fact, she just left here a few minutes ago.
Okay, look, look. Those are people from my past. They don't mean anything. Look, don't pay them any mind, okay? Just forgive them.
Anita told me that you were seeing both her and me at the same time. Is that true, Mark?
Look, I've been knowing Anita for some years now, okay? And occasionally, we would just have casual sex. That's all it was. She didn't mean anything to me.
So you could find time to have sex with her, but you can't have sex with me?
After I got with her, I stopped. After I got with you, baby, I stopped having sex with her.
Okay. All right. So what about Shane? He told me that you used to work for him as a male escort and that you're on the down low. Is that true?
No, I am not on the down low. I used to work as a male escort. And it required me to do some things I'm not proud of.
How could you do this to me? How could you bring me into your world of perversion?
Okay, listen, I'm not doing those things
anymore. Don't touch me! Anita told me that you are HIV positive. Is that true, Mark?
That's for me. It may be true, baby, but I have to take more tests just to confirm that. Somebody.
So when were you planning on telling me all about your little secret? You know, Mark, I really thought you were different.
I am different, baby. I am.
Yeah, you can say that again. I can't believe that I trust you around my baby. Please
don't
tell me you hurt my
son. Taylor, now you know I would never do anything to hurt Malik. I love Malik.
I don't know what to believe because I don't even know who the real Mark Collins really is.
I am the same Mark Collins that you fell in love with, baby. Please. Please, Taylor, don't hold my past against me.
I hate you! And I'm so mad at myself for giving you my heart, my soul, and my body. What if I'm sick?
I'm sorry.
What if I'm sick, Mark?
Baby, you got to believe me, Taylor. Trust me, everything will be fine, Taylor. I promise you. Taylor, I'm sorry.
No, you're not sorry. No, don't say that. Just get out and don't come back. Get out!
Thank you.
No, he hasn't made it into the office. He may take a message.
Gina, is
yes, he'll
that
be
me?
Here later. Can you please place me on hold for a moment? Thank you.
Is that call for me? I'm sorry, I didn't mean it.
No, it's for your father.
Okay, well, I mean, do I have any messages?
Yes, sir, just one. It's from Mr. Larry Martin. He wanted you to return his call.
That very well could be the message I've been waiting for. I kind of wish it was from Gina, though. I mean, from Taylor. I really miss Taylor, and I wish Taylor was here.
I'm sure everything will be all right, but can you please excuse me? I really need to finish taking this. Thank you for holding. Yes, I'll make sure Mr. Connors gets this message. Thank you. You have a great day. Thank you for calling Connors at Connors' offer. Goodbye.
I'm not going to hold you up. I'll be in my office if you need me.
Yes, sir, Mr. Connors, but before you leave, can I ask you a question?
Sure. What's going on?
Are you all right? You just don't seem very happy these days.
Honestly, Gina, I just feel like I'm kind of just walking around in a daze. I mean, my father will barely talk to me. Taylor won't answer any of my calls. And Anita, as you know, is bringing this lawsuit against me. I'm doing everything in my power to avoid Shane Lucas as much as possible. So I guess other than that, I guess I'm fine.
Well, I know that you said you're a Christian, but do you really trust in God?
Yeah, of course I do.
Do you really believe that there's nothing too hard for God to do?
Yeah.
Have you stopped and prayed and asked God to take care of all your problems?
No, not really. I think God is probably mad at me too.
If only you knew how much God really loves you and that nothing can separate us from the love of God, what seems impossible for man is very possible for God.
So what you're telling me is that no matter how big of a mess I've made of my life, that God is able to turn it all around?
Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying. God has his own way of restoring things. You just have to believe. Some things are just a test of our faith.
You know what? I do believe. Thank you, Gina. I really need to hear that.
Good morning, Gina.
Good morning, Mr. Collins.
Good morning, Father.
You know, Gina, it really is a wonderful day for a good game of golf, but too bad I got to work. Anyway, I have any messages?
Yes, sir. This message is for you.
I've been waiting on this call all week.
Gina, look. I'll be in my office if you need.
Okay. Yeah, hopefully getting some much needed work done.
Mr. Collins, I know that this doesn't concern me, but can you please just talk to your son? He really does need you right now.
No, I can't talk to that boy. He needs to talk to Jesus. I hope he does it before it's too late.
Well, we all make mistakes, and God says that he'll forgive us for our mistakes, but we have to forgive others.
But that boy will mess up so bad this time. I'm just disappointed in him. That boy's really let me down.
But wasn't it just a few days ago when you said that you were so very proud of him? What changed?
Well, that changed the day he admitted to me a sinful lifestyle.
But that was his past. He doesn't do those things anymore. How long will you hold that against him?
You know, Gina, like you said, this really doesn't concern you. So why don't you go ahead and get Miss Natalie Kelly on the line? I think she has some questions about her husband's will.
Okay. Gina, whenever you get a chance, can you book me a one-way flight to Kansas City?
Yes, sir, Mr. Collins. I'll take care of it right away. But did you say one-way?
Yes, I did. I decided to take another position at another law firm in Kansas City.
So when were you going to tell me about this?
I guess the day you decided you wanted to start talking to me again.
I see. You say you're a changed man, but I see some things still haven't changed, son.
And what is that supposed to mean?
I'll tell you what it means. You know, just like always, every time things don't seem to go your way, you just chuck your little tail and run off. But son, let me tell you something. That ain't gonna solve anything, right?
Okay. Well, you seem to have all the answers, Pops. Why don't you tell me what you think I should do then?
Oh, well, first of all, you just need to man up and face reality, boy.
man up and face, oh, like you always man it up facing reality. Why don't you take responsibility for some of the things that you've done?
I built this empire around here.
I said, yeah, you built the empire, but what about all the other stuff that you've done?
Mr. Collins, I really need to answer this. Good morning, Collins and Collins Law Firm. How may I help you?
Not like you ain't never seen him.
Yes, he's in the office. Yes, of course he can. Can you hold on one moment?
Who is it, Gina?
Mr. Collins. It's for Mr. Mark Collins. I'm sorry, but it's someone calling from your doctor's office.
Maybe they're calling this time to let you know you got cancer.
Mr. Collins, please don't say ugly things like that. That's not nice.
You mind if I take it?
No, right go ahead. Go ahead.
Hello, yes, this is Mark Collins. Yes, yes, the doctor called me. Yes, that is my doctor, yes. Ma'am, I do understand that, and I know that's exactly. Wait, what do you mean, a mistake? Wait, are you sure? No, I mean, are you absolutely sure that this is not a mistake this time?
Oh my God. Thank you, ma'am. Yes, thank you for calling me. Oh my God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. I'm not HIV positive. Are you trying to hide away the test results got confused? I'm not. Son, looks like God has given you a second chance at life. Yes.
I know. But what about you, man? Can you forgive me for all my past mistakes?
I forgive you a long time ago.
Can't really tell.
Oh, it ain't gonna matter anyway.
You haven't said but a few words to me since all of this came out.
That's all, that ain't gonna matter anyway. And didn't you just say you were leaving?
You know what, you're right. I am leaving. Because if God has given me a new chance, I mean, why not start over completely? You know, I gotta deal with this, because this is...
Mr. Collins, please don't say things you will regret later.
No.
I mean everything that I just said. You know what, as a matter of fact, I quit. Look, let me go get my stuff out of this office.
Wait a minute, don't you mean out of my office? You don't pay no
Mr.
bills.
Mr. Collins, please don't buzz in my carry out. Get him off, please.
Chance, where are you? Chance! I know you're here because you don't go nowhere. Chance!
What? I mean, what happened?
What's Chance, guess on? What? Guess what, man? I'm moving to Kansas. Can you believe that? I'm moving to Kansas. I took a position in Kansas. I'm moving.
Yes, I'm that going is to some good news for you. I'm so happy for you.
Well, you sure don't look like you're so happy for me.
Well, because if you moving to Kansas City, that means I need to find a new place to stay.
Oh, wait a minute. What happened to your job in Chicago?
Yeah, I thought I was going to have a job in Chicago, but that has changed also.
Well, I mean, what happened?
Yeah, because of you, Shane don't want to help me no more.
Well, look here, man, that's probably best anyway. I mean, that dude cannot be trusted.
But I really wanted that job. I'm just so ready to go back to work. You don't understand.
Okay, well, look here. If you're really ready to go back to work, I can talk to the old man. And you could work over there at the law firm, you know, until he find my replacement.
No, thanks, but no thanks. Besides, I know how he feels about gay people, so I don't want to be bothered with him.
Yeah. I guess you're right about that. But, I mean, when did you find out you wasn't getting that position in Chicago anyway, though?
Oh, yeah, I found that out, man, just about a few minutes ago.
Dude, what are you doing here?
Still trying to settle my scores with you.
I've already told you that I will pay you whatever debt I owe you.
And you can start paying them off by bringing your sorry ass back to Chicago.
Look, I told you
what you owe me.
I'm not doing that.
Oh,
I'm not doing that anymore. I'm not going with you.
Oh, okay. Or you will be coming back to Chicago.
Whatever, man.
Or your life.
Oh, my God.
You hear me? What you jumping around for? What was wrong with him?
Look, shut up.
You better calm down.
Just put the gun away. You really don't want to do this.
Don't be too sure about it. Go ahead, answer it.
All right. Okay.
So what's wrong with him?
Look, calm down. Man, calm down.
Who is it?
It's
Anita. Is Marco home?
I don't know.
Man, go ahead, let her in.
Okay, all right.
I'm sure I have enough bullets just in case I need to shoot somebody else.
Come on in.
Better be still.
Hey, Chad. It's Mark home. I just need to talk to him.
Hey.
But it's a bad time, and I'm going to...
Oh, you think? You think, huh? Just come over here and sit your tail down. I haven't seen.
I just wanted to talk to Mark, but it's a bad time. I can come back.
No, come and sit your tail down.
Right, Joe,
I haven't seen.
About it.
Man, what? You got some kind of circus going
Shane,
on here? Is that why you want to come back to Chicago? Because you started your own escort business?
No, man.
What's wrong with you?
Somebody.
Go ahead, answer it.
Hey, all right.
The more the merrier.
Who is it?
It's Taylor.
It's Taylor.
Let her in, too. I'm sure she needs to talk to Mark.
All right. Come on in.
Hey, Chance, I just came to drop off Mark's stuff.
Hey.
Anita, what are you doing here?
Come on in here. Come on in here. You get your tail over here. Sit down. Sit down.
Please don't kill me. I have a son who really needs me.
I got girls. Please, they need me too.
This is why I told you you should call before you come over here. Shay. Just put the gun away, man. You really don't want to do this, man. Just,
this doesn't really concern me. Can I just say what I need to say and leave?
Well, go ahead, because I'm expecting all this drama anyway.
Okay.
I got a plane I need to catch.
You better be still.
Calm down, please. Look, Mark, I just came by to apologize and tell you I know the truth. So, you know,
I think everybody knows the truth by now, Anita.
Still.
It's not. Look, your dad called me a few days ago. He said I didn't have a case against you because you're not HIV positive.
But
I already knew that, Mark.
Yes, it's true. But wait a minute, what do you mean you already knew that?
Jarvis called.
Who?
Jarvis. I was involved with him. His wife just recently passed away of AIDS, so that's where I got it from, not you. I'm sorry, Mark.
Look, it's fine.
Okay.
Please.
Can I go?
Man, this really is some kind of circus. And what about you, Lily? You got something you want to say?
I just came by to drop my first
stuff. Man, what is going on here? Not again. Man, go ahead and answer.
Who is it?
Man.
Come on in. I'm not doing nothing.
Hello, Chance. Where's Mark? I really need to talk to him before he leaves. Have you seen him? Have you talked to him anything? Come on in here, Mr. Collins. You just in time to join in this little freak party. Get in here.
Look, man, what are you doing here?
Look, son, I just came by here to tell you I'm sorry and let you know that I want to support you in anything you do. But, man, what is going on here? Are you just in time to say your final goodbyes to your son?
Wait a minute, man. What do you mean?
You have anything else you need to say?
Look, that's my son. Please don't hurt him. That's the only son I have, and I love him, too.
Hey, man, I tell you what. You hear me?
Okay.
You better be still.
Okay. I'm still.
Your son is either coming back to Chicago with me and pay off what he's owed me, or he's going there to meet his maker.
Okay. Don't hurt my son. Please don't hurt him.
Let go, man. This ain't concerned you. This only concerns me.
Okay.
Be still.
Look, I will go back to Chicago with you. Shay, just please, just don't hurt anybody here. Okay? Please.
Can I please leave? I don't have anything to do
with it. Let me leave when I say you can leave! Now shut the hell up!
How it all ends? today, which may be my last breath. Oh God, if I only had more time. But Jesus, I know that you're real. God, I come now asking for your forgiveness. I know that I've made some mistakes and I've hurt a lot of people along the way. But on this day, Lord, if you're calling me home, I simply ask for a place in your kingdom where I can serve you for an eternity.